couple of years ago when this project was being conceived, if someone had asked me to describe what comes to mind when you think of technology for the blind, I probably would have imagined, you know, someone who's been blind for most of their life, who is using something like a Braille display, which is a technology they would learn to use as soon as they could after the onset of blindness. In fact, for the roughly 250 million or so people worldwide with moderate to severe visual impairment, the majority of them, their impairment arises from age-related medical conditions. Due to a growing and globally aging world population, the number of visually impaired people is expected to continue to rise, and an even greater fraction of this population is going to be there due to age-related causes. We live, obviously, in a very technological world. Accessible technology allows visually impaired individuals a higher quality of life and a greater degree of independence. To understand how we can make a difference with this growing segment of the population that suffers from age-related visual impairments, we really need to see what is available today. Audio is by far the most widespread assistive modality for vision loss. The major benefit of audio is it can be implemented fairly easily with current technology, off-the-shelf technology, but unfortunately it doesn't cover all the use cases. Firstly, studies show that people are reluctant to draw attention to their disability, whether due to self-consciousness or privacy concerns or safety concerns. So the device that kind of advertises to everyone around you, hey, I'm visually impaired, is not always desirable. Secondly, with regard to aging, vision loss is frequently accompanied by, of course, hearing loss. By age 70, it's estimated it's going to affect about 10 to 20% of us, and of course, it's not going to get any better as we age. In the tactile world, by far the most dominant version is Braille in its various forms. Braille has been and continues to be very important to the blind community. It's efficient and versatile, but it is a very difficult undertaking for someone to learn an entirely new code of communication late in life, especially if vision loss occurs gradually. And Braille, of course, tends to be quite costly. To state our design problem more clearly, we want a solution that's very compact, small enough for wearables that are taken outside the home where audio technology has the most limitations, something that's inexpensive at low to medium production volumes. A tactile device like this will never have an iPhone-level market because, that can truly harness the economies of scale. And it should have little to no learning curve to facilitate adoption by people who develop visual impairment in late life and are unable or unwilling to learn a whole new writing system like Braille. It's obvious that the cost of a tactile solution scales with the number of actuators needed to operate it. Braille is actually the most efficient such solution. It's essentially a binary code, but that's what makes it a little harder to learn. On the other end of the spectrum, we have dot matrix displays. They're the most versatile, can display almost anything with enough resolution, but actuator density and quantity scales accordingly. The multi-segment display is something that should be familiar to everyone here. It's in countless electronic devices, can represent, anywhere from the set of numbers and some letters with the basic 7-segment display to the entire alphanumeric alphabet with 14 to 16 segments. It's easily recognizable without having to learn a whole new encoding, but it does allow us to use fewer actuators compared to something like a dot matrix display. It's also familiar to everyone, and which kind of supports the notion that a tactile version would be usable with little to no prior training. We're envisioning a straightforward path to tactile versions of existing devices, watches, fitness trackers, health monitors, certain medical devices such as glucometers, and eventually perhaps appliances and communication devices. Another interesting idea to bring up here is the idea of hybrid visual and tactile feedback. Once you have a tactile version, it's fairly trivial to have segments that both rise and illuminate as they rise. So our typical end user might be someone who is starting to encounter age-related vision loss. They begin by focusing primarily on the visual feedback, and then as their vision worsens, they transition to tactile. As part of this validation project, we're extending this design philosophy to the rest of the device. We're trying to not only build out the rest of the system and produce a fully functional prototype, but to do it in a way that can directly transition to existing manufacturing processes if a licensee or a spin-out decides to put these in the product. Although we built these initial prototypes using our fancy in-house fabrication tools, one of the things we've budgeted for is to engage external vendors as much as possible and to replace our in-lab manufactured components with components that are manufactured in the way they will be in a commercial product. To summarize, we're developing a multi-segment tactile technology that primarily targets age-related vision loss. It can replace or augment alphanumeric readouts in accessible products. We place a heavy emphasis on minimizing cost and having a path to manufacturing. Once we nail down these design parameters for the characters, this will allow us to freeze the microactuator design and to pave the way for a full system prototype in 2019.